I'll multiply this with 0.2 just to keep it slower, and you see that the texture starts moving. So you can create a stream, a water stream. I'll just give a small stretch in it, and then you see a stretch pattern, and then you get that flowing water effect. Hi, my name is Vishal. Let's see the fractal texture in Maya. For that, I'm opening the hyper shade, and here we have the fractal texture in the 2D section. So let's explore it. For that, I'm just creating a simple polygonal plane, scaling it up, assigning a shader. I'm pressing Shift T on the keyboard so that you get this create node or assign new material window. And I'm applying Lambert shader. And in the color, I'll take the fractal texture. Press 6 on the keyboard to see the texture there. So it's a simple random texture, noisy pattern, which can be used to create patterns like clouds. It can be used patterns for rocks and anything which has got this kind of pattern, for example moss or high frequency details on tree bark or anything like that. You can use them in specularity to create specular variation and a lot like that. So we have different options in the amplitude. In the fractal, the amplitude, it is the amount of values you are scaling up. So you are increasing the whites, and you are increasing the blacks of the texture. Earlier it was defaultly gray color, so mid value gray, and then negatives are the deeps are going deep, and the peaks are coming more on the peak side. Okay, I'm just thinking about in the displacement map perspective. Okay, you can also go to the utility section and create a utility called height field utility. Okay, this creates a plane. Okay, and if I press 4, it will be in the wireframe, and you see the divisions. And then when I increase the resolution, okay, you get more resolution there. And in the displacement, I'll put the fractal. Okay, now you see the amplitude 0, amplitude 1. So things which are coming up are coming up. Things which are going down are going down. Okay, which is okay. You see the black and white. So from gray, blacks are forming and whites are forming. So they are the peaks and their valleys. White color is a peak and black color is a valley. So you have the threshold here where you could see the when I'm increasing the value, the 0 to 1 range is offsetting to the higher, and then as it is touching the 1, it is getting clamped over there. Okay, you can see that. I've put this texture only to make you understand how these things are working there. Okay, we have the ratio option here. You could see it's controlling the size of this noise pattern. And this, I think, I'll put the same texture on both of them and then see the threshold. Just see where these patterns can be possibly used. Anything on stones, file stones. What's happening with the ratio? And what's happening with the frequency ratio? So when I was using this ratio, there was small scaled noise, and I'm controlling that small scaled noise within the big scaled noise. So we have the level minimum and level maximum, which will control the granules of the secondary details there. If you could see, I'm increasing the level max value, and it's sort of controlling them. So we are controlling what should be the minimum and maximum range of it. We have bias, which again changes the value range of the existing texture, which makes it more contrast or takes the whole texture to a new contrast level. Maybe you can try creating Grand Canyons in the displacement map there. So we have the inflection, which you can see changes the total effect, the pattern of the fractal. And I reduce amplitude and see the it can be used in creating the skin of the reptiles. Not every reptile, but any reptile which basically suits. Okay, even this looks very weird, cracked ground, but it's more round. Okay, we have the animated option here, which will animate the overall texture. Every time I see the time, I just write equals to time expression and then hit enter. Then I hit play, you see that sort of boiling. If you feel it's too fast, you can always right click, edit expression, and you see there is I'm just holding control and using the scroll, and then the text is becoming bigger. The fractal to time is equals to time. I can multiply with a less a value than one, can reduce the speed there. Now if I hit play, you get this. Okay. So we have this time ratio. What this time ratio does is it will scale the speed of the waves based on the frequency size. For example, if you could see, there are two different scaled noises. Now, one is the bigger one, okay, and the other one is the smaller one, okay, the small one. So there are small noises, and the other one is the big noise, the big one, the smaller one. So time ratio is something which makes those waves animate in relation with the higher frequency to the lower frequency ratio. So the bigger wave speed in relation with the smaller wave speed is controlled. So if I play it and increase the time ratio, you see the waves, the bigger one are speed, and much more speed the smaller waves are. So controlling how fast, it's all about controlling the time scale of this wave frequencies in simple words. Okay. You can keep exploring different options. As I said, you can use this to create displacement maps, bump maps. If you apply this to displacement map, yes, you can create a nice simple looking water surface. And you can go to the placement mode, and in the translate frame, we can just write an expression called time. I'll multiply this with 0.2 just to keep it slower, and you see that the texture starts moving. So you can create a stream, a water stream. I'll just give a small stretch in it, and then you see a stretch pattern, and then you get that flowing water effect. So not only that, if you're creating a rough terrain, you want to create the mud. So I'll just create a plane, and then assign a blend shader, and I just take some mud color and then make it look glossy. And then in bump map, I'll take the fractal texture, and you see you got some wet mud or dirt. So as I said, you can explore. You got the amplitude, you got the threshold, you see how nice it looks. This looks like a nice dried up water pond, and you got that nice lumps here and there, or a textured paper effect. You see, that's one layer of the noise, and this is another layer of the noise. Very beautiful surfaces can be created. Even stucco wall pattern, or anything like mud wall or tribal architecture, I can say. So I can use all of them here. Let's see what combination works for you. And you can, on the top of this, okay, you can add further textures. For example, here we got alpha gain. Okay, in alpha gain we can add other texture which can control the overall texture there. So it's an additional layer to our existing. Now you got that dots, and on the top you got the it's like mixing up two different textures there. Inflection is bad. A secondary layer onto the surface. Just a wet pond, I can say. You can also use to create stones and all that. I'm assigning a simple blend shader and I'm choosing fractal, reducing the amplitude. We're getting the pull because of the UV placement. This is a 2D texture, and in the bump map I'll take the fractal, reducing the amplitude, and then there we go. See what suits your requirement and then add accordingly. Any organic surfaces you can create.